dead draw gaming. Like no one ever was.
Hello, hello, and welcome back to round 14 of the Madison Regional Championship. I'm Kirk Dupesnacks Dubé, alongside Jeff Saran Rap Saran. We have our two players shuffling up right now. We're going to pitch to that in just a moment. And you'll feel like you got a little bit of deja vu because we've got Wesley back in the feature match area. And that is because Nolan Freda playing Lapras is on a winning end.
I tweeted earlier that I prayed that there's a Lapras here in this spot, and lucky enough, Nolan marched his way through the top 32, and is in the position to have a winning end potentially. Also, you can probably add on to that.
We say potentially because Jeff and I kind of looked at the numbers, did a quick breakdown, and the amount of unintentional draws that happened last round and a couple of the rounds previous have put it that maybe three 32 pointers miss on this top eight.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully, we are not notable. Yep. Mr. Robot Chris Shemansky. We are not the data miners, the Mathema Wizards, I think is what they're called. So that's the best we could do on the fly with our limited knowledge, but we feel like there might be a couple to miss. Let's just hope that it's not one of these gentlemen we have on stream right now.
Yeah, I think it would be such a heartbreaking moment that if no one does pull this out and we see him in a nice spot, that I might flip a table here and go home.
Well, unfortunately, Jeff, we've got the top eight to cover, so we're going to need you for that. However, let's talk about the dichotomy of this matchup here. We have Wesley Hollenberg, as we know, is on the Buzzwole Garbodor variant, and Nolan playing Lapras. What does that matchup look like? What is going to hinder Nolan? What is Garbotoxin going to do to him?
You know, Garbotoxin is going to do a couple of things here. Late game Lele's are going to be ineffective, but more importantly, it's going to be losing the Mantiv EX. Being able to rotate in and out between the Laprases, whether using their Blizzard Burn attack, is going to be crucial for that moment there. And on his end, there's only one Field Blower,
which is one more than most have been playing today from what we've seen on stream. Mm-hmm. So at least Nolan isn't completely out in the woods. He does have that one Field Blower. I think if he can use that very strategically and use it to reactivate Aqua Tube on a pivotal turn, take a big knockout, then that can be kind of how he swings the game into his favor.
Absolutely. And then, on the flip side of that too, Wesley has a couple different outs here. But I think this matchup is interesting to where, no one can kind of explode between the Aqua Patches and the Max Elixirs. And Wesley has that mid-game with the Beast Rings. So going back to our point before is, if Nolan can kind of control the pace of prizes, 1-3, so on and so forth there, and hold back Wesley's Beast Rings, we could be in a pretty good battle here.
Interesting to note, Wesley is playing Fighting Fury Belt, which is a lot different than Choice Band Knockout that Nolan has probably been used to all weekend on these Buzzwoles.
So maybe one of those things here to where, from the previous match we saw before, maybe Nolan can get the Volcanion Prism Star.
Yep.
Up and rolling really quickly. It's tough with that 3 water energy energy count, but if you can get that up and rolling quickly and start chipping away at the buzz on the bench, and then let Lapras come in and hit the Grand Slams, they'll bring the game home.
Another good thing that Nolan can do, if he is jammed up a little bit in those Fighting Fury Belts, is do the best he can with what he's got, put damage everywhere, and then maybe hit that late game Field Blower to knock off those Fury Belts and take prizes that way, kind of in the middle of his turn.
Yep.
Wesley off to the races here so with the Tapu Lele start, getting down Buzzwole GX.
Yep.
Tapu Lele grabbing Lily.
And now Bubba's Lele's are on the field, so we won't be seeing them at all the rest of the game. So Lele's did his part now. So, but I think actually Lele's pretty strong in this matchup. You put a 5 Fury Belt on a Lele with the energy with a couple energy on energy drive on these Laprases with 3 energy.
We see a Lily up to 8 for Wes. It is the first turn of the game. That is what that card reads. Fighting Fury Belt and energy down on the Buzzwole. Floatstone on
order
the Tapu Lele. You are just the worst luck for Wes when you yell order pad.
You got next dibs.
All right.
On the order pad. And if it comes true, then I'm staying quiet on those.
Order pad fail. Wes content with what's in his hand. Doesn't want to make any rash actions. Guzma on the Lele without a Floatstone. Remoraid attach.
Collect.
Love it. Collect. little turn of a reprieve there. Wes does play the maximum amount of Flowstone allowed, 4. So there is an opportunity for him to get out of this without too much damage. We see another basic energy coming down on the Buzzwole. Mm-hmm. Buzzwole GX hits the bench. Cynthia, probably going to be looking for that Flowstone to get the Tepu Lele out of the active. Nolan obviously hoping to fade that Flowstone so he can kind of continually set up his game plan.
You know, I think Nolan got to start, you know, he sees Fighting Fury Belt now. He has to start weighing out his options on how to just slowly chip away at that extra 40 HP that comes. Lapras doesn't have a chip attack. It's just a Blizzard Burn and a Paralyze. And you know what? The Paralyze can actually come into a good play there. Paralyze the Buzzwole, leave it active, then return a knockout with the Blizzard Burn.
Yep. We see Nestbolt coming down. First Trubbish of the game. Wes has got to know with Lapras comes Manaphy. With Manaphy comes Free Retreat with Water Energy. So getting one of those down this turn, maybe one turn later than he'd like, mm-hmm. but not completely so far behind that it's irrelevant. Also going to be able to limit the amount of turns that Nolan's going to be able to use Octillery, which he has.
Yep, so we have Cynthia bringing it back down. Octillery has been dropped, and Lele is still stuck. There's a brick at his feet, and he's in the flow, so to lift him up. So
yeah. He is, or he or she, Tapu Lele, heavy in the front.
Legendaries are genderless.
Duly noted. the genderless legendary.
We'll leave that staying
heavy
BGC
up front.
Guys.
It's sitting up front. We're not going to try and cause any static with that. Cynthia, Nolan. Nolan going to draw 6 here. Getting a little silly in the booth one time. Let's see what Nolan can peel. Probably wants to get another attacker going. Accelerate some energies.
We need some pieces here. We need this puzzle scattered around. We need some aqua patches. Need some elixirs. Need some love.
Nolan is playing 13 water, similar to Nick that we saw yesterday. Mm-hmm. Ultra Ball, an easy discard with the water. You know, going to be able to activate his aqua patch. His aqua patches, plural.
You know, I don't think this is a strong option here, but that hug attack on Octillery could make some unique plays to hold those Buzzwoles in an active spot.
I mean, you do what you can do to win a game, right? Nolan eyeing up a Lapras. I think that's a great call. Didn't see everything in his hand. However, you know, really wants to put some work in right now with that Aqua Patch, with those Max Elixirs, and try and get ahead of Wes before he can establish more than one Buzzwole.
Yeah, as long as Lele's stuck active here, I think Nolan just needs to keep, you know, rolling punches, Elixir, Aqua Patch, load these Lapras up.
Yep.
I still want to see that Volcanion come down, but we'll see what happens when we get here. And
Big hit.
I'd
three
be surprised
waters
if he hits a max list for this game, but from Nick's matchup from day one, he did with quite a few. So
we've got a little poll going on in the chat. A lot of you looking to get Lapras a W and hopefully into this top 8, seeing something new. A beacon.
Yep.
Of light in the darkness that is the Buzzwole.
6 Buzzwoles, 1 Lapras, 1 Palamar. We shall see.
Nolan is having an insane turn off that Cynthia. Aqua Patch, Ultra Ball for Lapras, Aqua Patch, hit Max Elixir, powered up Lapras, Abyssal Hand for 5.
He is
going to work.
He's surfing the waves right now, and his tsunami's about to crash on his Lele.
If he... Oh, man. Collect again, lots of cards. Guzma in his hand, a key one. If one of those Buzzwoles doesn't get that Fighting Fury belt on it, he can take a quick hit on that. You know, they do play the 4 choice band to be able to deal the damage. A Fighting Fury belt being used up
Uh-oh.
On the Garbodor here Uh-oh. Is big. It's very big.
Oh, no. This is going to be
an Absorption GX.
Just take out the Lapras right away, but... How Lele
that's okay. There's another.
There.
There's more Max Elixirs. There's Aqua Patches in Nolan's hand. Hopefully he has a Floatstone somewhere in there.
See, he had a Guzman hand too. From what I saw. So I mean, it could have been a play there where he brought the Octillery, did some Aqua Patches, Guzma. But I think he's looking at a different route here.
Brooklet Hill coming down. Lapras number 3 hitting the board. He only does play 3, so that's definitely worth noting. And 0 ways to buy them back.
Nope, no recovery here. So once those Lapras are gone, their pair slog it in and discard.
They are gone.
So lots of options here, but you've got Aqua Patches, you got Energies in hand, so this Lapras can get full, and an Elixir. This Lapras can get fully loaded quickly, but with him losing those 3 Energies and him using quite a few of his Energy Accelerators already, mm-hmm. He has to hold strong with these cards right now and make the best use of them.
Hit Max Elixir, Aqua Patch right on there. Lapras is getting built up very quickly. Very, very quickly. Trying to work his hand down to maybe Abyssal Hand for a few more cards. He has his Attachment Turn Energy Switch. There it is. Two copies of it. Two copies of it. Do we have a choice band? We have a Cynthia. So I know when he was going through, looking through his deck with Brooklyn Hill, we did see two choice bands.
This could be a big thing here. Choice band Field Blower right now. It take this knockout. While yes, it is puts him in Beast Ring Zone, but Wesley has the guard in there, so he can't do too much.
Yeah, no other attackers powered up. However, Energy Beast Ring does kind of get him there. We might see a Paralysis here. We might see the Ice Beam GX. That way he's not completely priced in.
Oh my gosh.
That is an energy heavy hand, and it is a 13 energy
deck.
That
hand is dripping wet. There's so much water in there.
He does have an Ultra Ball, but not going to be able to use that too much. Garbotoxin is live, which we had noted with when he attached the Fighting Fury Belt. Elixir coming down.
Does he hit this one?
Maybe.
That'd be pretty spicy. I didn't think so. He had like four in his hand, so.
Kind of a Lemony Snicket series of unfortunate events with the Cynthia there. You know, I like it. I think it's humorous. We're going to go with it.
We have the go-tos, and you know, they hit hard sometimes.
Ice Beam GX has been announced.
You turn right, homie.
It is paralyzed. Guzma, the only way out of this one. Flowstone on the Lele does make it.
An option here if he does have the Guzma, but I like the play of the Paralysis here. It also sets back Wesley one turn. I'm getting these energies on board quickly. But if he just holds these Beast Rings and lets Lapras take this knockout next turn. I was waiting for you to say it.
It went off screen. Order pad! Nope.
You know what? I think
we cursed him.
We had a latency.
We cursed him.
And saying order pad, and I think that's what the issue was.
Strong energy, setting up that backup buzz. With the end means that Nolan is going to be able to take these prizes here. Wes just trying to see a couple Beast Rings off the top. Maybe another draw supporter be able to take that return KO on Lapras and be down to two prizes with Nolan not much going on.
Yeah, another thought here. I would like to, and I'm going to keep bringing up this Volcanion here because with that 100 there now, you bring in the Volcanion and start spreading damage. You don't take prizes until later, which means Beast Rings come into effect too fast. Now, that could be enough time for Wesley to put manually attached energies, but it forces him to take out a knockout on a one prize attacker.
We see a pass here. Paralysis comes off. Choice Band off the top. I think I saw a Guzma as well. Aqua Patch. Okay, so he can Guzma, Choice Band, get the Buzzwole in the back, and then he has a knockout on the active Buzzwole.
Oh, there we go.
There we go. So this is a big, big turn. Big, big turn.
The Fighting Fury Belt going on the Garbodor is kind of biting him now. And
yep.
Not be able to put
he could have prioritized that. He wanted to get
the lockdown.
The lock in place. Kind of limit the use of Octillery.
The lockdown of the Loch Ness Monster.
is that what it is?
That's
We're
what
going
it is.
With Nessie.
I searched it and I was like, I think he's the Loch Ness
Nolan
Monster.
Nolan with the Nessie aggro. going in. Blizzard Burn knockout down to four. Beast Rings active. However, we have a heavily damaged Buzz ready to get eaten alive.
Oh, this is a really good spot for Nolan to be in right now, but Beast Ring's about to come in and put in the work. Buzzwole is getting swole.
We do have a clean Buzz. Strong energy might not be too bad going in.
Mm-hmm.
Floatstone.
Just get rid of some of the cards here.
Yep. Really, Wes really wants to take a knockout here in any way, shape, form possible.
So right now, currently, let's see if I can do
160 plus 30, 190. We're good. He's got it on the Lapras. He's got the Lapras. Nolan has the Lapras.
Random receiver. Ooh, nice. He was excited about that. Yeah, shaking his hand in triumphant.
The gold random receiver, one of. He said, I'm not going to spend a lot of money on these other cards, but I only play one random receiver. I'm going to go ahead and
bling it out.
I'm going to go ahead and make sure that's max rarity.
Put that $2 to great use.
Look, you didn't have to bring that up. Like, you don't have to take out a second mortgage to be playing with highest rarity. Our boy Glenn flexing the wallet yesterday in round 9 with all those super, super spicy hyper rares.
He had three Chevys all in one deck. With all the money he had in that.
He had three of my mortgage payments in one deck. We see the free retreat due to the floatstone here, going to the Buzzwole. Knuckle Impact taking a knockout. Nolan here with.
Is that right?
Okay, hold on.
This might be a prize thing. I think Wesley was already at.
Oh, we see the hams go out to the head. Something happened here.
I'm going to go check over there to get the actual revert on. I'll be right back.
Jeff is running out of the booth, going to bounce over to the game to see what's going on. We're getting an update from the judge here. Alright, we are resolving. We're having a few issues. Luckily, nothing wrong with the game state. It is, unfortunately, a technical issue that have kind of run rampant these last two rounds, unfortunately. Jeff, what's the word?
Yeah, so we're going to do a couple things. So the prize thing is not an issue there. Wesley did take the right prizes. The reaction there was because the white noise was taken out. So currently he can't hear us, as well as the system outside. So we're throwing a couple options out there of maybe turning down the speaker outside, or because of the current delay on the speaker, maybe that might play into effect too bad with the game. So a couple options here that the head judge is going to come over and discuss with Corey there.
Okay. Definitely want to make sure that everything is on the straight and narrow for these players, giving them the maximum opportunity to, you know, play their game and earn themselves this top eight here in Madison. Until then, again, we can't really divulge too much into the decks, the list, now that we know that they can hear us. So what do you expect, obviously, this top eight to be? We've got Buzzwole, we've got Zorax everywhere, we might have Buzzgarb, Lapras, Limpin. Let's start here. Over, under, four Buzzwole in top eight.
Absolutely over. Buzzwole's completely dominating these top tables right now, across the board, whether it's the Garb version, the Baby Buzz, rolling in deep together kind of version. It's insane. All that fighting power is coming through, and I mean, like I said before, you can see anywhere from 5 to 7, depending on how these percentages go in the opponent's win percentage. So
absolutely, we know it's definitely not 8 because Zach. Well, Zach, now Zach with now with 32, not
he's going to be 33 points if he IDs his last round. So Zach is sealed. He was 10-1-1 going his round. Zach has sealed his position.
Beautiful.
So
that's good to know. So we will see.
But these 32s are out here, you know, sucking their thumbs, you know, in the field position, praying that they get that money.
That they slide in and don't take the bitter heartbreak of 9th or 10th in this tournament.
Especially, you know, after you hear 32 should be good, and then if our position's right, what we assess that you might be one of the two or three that miss, ouch.
Ouch. Very ouch. We have Buzzwole mirrors all over the place now at the top tables. A couple of the big name players, as we'll call them, were saying that the straight Buzzrock mirrors not as skill intensive as they would necessarily like for this current scenario.
And but I will say that if we do run a situation to where it's the there we go. We're actually back. I'm not sure if our headphones are back there, if their headphones are back working or not, or if we're just gonna kind of keep it down. All right, we got the thumbs up. We're all good to go, and we're back into the game.
So we see Ultra Ball for another Remoraid. We know, as we mentioned before, two Laprases down, no Laprases left, just one on board with those three water is what Nolan has to try and close the door on this thing. We have Volcanion that can step up and do some work.
From looking at now, since he's got the Remoraid, it's either in his hand or his prized.
That's a great point. Manaphy is in his prized. Sycamore. 3, 6, 7. Let's see what he gets here. Aqua Patch, Sycamore, Octillery, Max Elixir. Don't tell me we're going to start seeing Hugs.
So we could see Hugs. A couple things there. Oh, man. I called it. He's going to grab that Garb. He's going to hug him.
Maximum friendship through the Octillery.
All eight legs. See. All eight tentacles. I apologize. They're going to be hugging him to hold him down. But if he holds these Max Elixir Aqua Patches, which he's using it now, it could be something to where if he gets the Volcanion off the prize, he could set it up that way.
Yep. we have a reader, folks. Wes is like, just making sure I know exactly what Hug does if it comes down to that. Max Elixir.
I can't believe we might see this.
Max Elixir hit. Nolan has really been able to employ his game plan this whole time.
It's quite strong.
He's been able to accelerate energy on the Lapras. That Fighting Fury Belt just you know, in any other matchup against Buzzwole, he would have been able to take a KO if he had the choice band. But now he was like, okay, even with the choice band, I can't take KO. I have to go for Ice Beam GX.
He has to have a strategy going into this, right? I think an Assault of Volcanion. He had to have a strategy going into this because through these five rounds, he had to have faced both versions, right? This version with the guard because there's two of them in the field, and also the triple baby version. So he has to have, at this point, come up with a game plan.
Yep. We see Wes using Brooklet Hill, getting a quick idea of what's left in his deck. It's fairly thin right now. Wes is down to an unpowered Buzzwole and a Buzzwole with two energy. He needs that energy to be able to start pressuring this Lapras back, because that Tapu Lele ready to get eaten. Yep. And neither of those Buzzwoles right now have that Fighting Fury belt.
Yep, and again, it's going back to putting that one Fighting Fury belt on Garbodor. You know, it's not showing up now when he needs it to defend himself. So 190 is a very easy number to hit.
Mystery Energy, he does have... excuse me, Mystery Energy, or what the heck am I talking about? Mysterious Treasure, thank you, Kirk.
Holla.
Shuffle and draw seven, we did it.
Yeah.
We got there. Ding. Ding, level up, we got
West
there.
West Fighting Hop on the board was like, hey man, I'll give you seven.
Exactly. The magic number here that Wes wants to hit is 190. Let's make it real simple with a retreat to Knuckle Impact, Strong Energy, Fighting Fury Belt here.
There's only one Fighting Fury Belt left in his deck, if I'm not mistaken, between the two that he has on board. Actually, it might be two left.
There's two left. He does play four, assuming it's not in his prizes.
Yep.
Hala gonna come through for that. We've got a scampering over to the table again.
There's verifying about the Mysterious Treasure that, like, there wasn't a shuffle after he did it, but it's because he just didn't search. He was burning cards. Got it all.
Strong Energy, Fighting Fury Belt. Holla. Holla, holla, holla coming through.
Holla running hot for the Hollenberg.
And that's why he plays it, right? Has to be. Holla playing Hollenberg, playing one copy of Holla. They're the same person now.
They're essentially. I forgot what they're calling in the game exactly. But
Wes was like, I'm going to, can I create a card? Call it Holla. Throw it in.
Holla.
Coming through. To be fair, his deck was very thin. He knew the contents of it with Mysterious Treasure, with that Brooklyn Hill search on that last turn. Very high odds there. We hadn't seen any real Strong Energy hit the board. I believe he still had three left in deck. Mm-hmm. Two Fighting Fury Belts in his deck, maybe had less than 20 cards in it.
Yep.
So drawing
very,
seven.
Very strong
cards. You know, he definitely understood exactly what he was playing to and had a very good chance to just close the door on it. Let's not play any longer than we have to. Let's just lock it in right now.
You know, I think, you know, those couple knockouts of losing the two Lapras early, and you know, I think going back to not having a Volcanion or access to it, you know, that kind of, you know, ruined Nolan's late game. Aquapache and Max listening to Octillery for send up a hug is not the route you want to go for victory.
0% chance that's how he wants that match to go. He will be on the play now, so maybe he can accelerate more than just attach collect for this turn. Maybe get another Lapras down, Lapras in the active, so he can start maybe doing collect and Max Elixir or energy, doing energy switches, things of that nature. Nolan really needs to put the pressure on in early, because Wes just manually attaching for three turns and then unloading a absorption GX on a benched Lapras that was powered up is not at all what Nolan wants to see. His deck is made to be faster than that.
This deck mirrors the old school Turbo Dark that we used to see in Expanded with the Dark Patches and Elixirs and how fast it gets set up. So if we can see that burst again here with a little more depth on his bench, I think he can go to distance in this game too.
Again, Nolan will be on the play looking for his starters. We see a Remoraid, a Brooklet Hill, which is nice.
Yeah,
we'll be able to get a Lapras down.
So do you think he's going to prioritize maybe the Volcanion this game, or is he just going to go straight to the Lapras game?
I think your order goes Lapras, Volcanion, depending on where the Fighting Fury belts go, things like that. If you need to spread that 20, how important that actually becomes to hit your numbers. You start Lapras. It's fairly tanky. You have to absorption it, or Knuckle Impact with a lot of bonuses. And as we know, until we hit that Beast Ring range, it's a slow burn for Wes to be able to set that up.
Yep, and I think going back to the play he did previously with the Ice Beam into the Blizzard Burn, that is a good route to take out one, but you need to take out 2-3.
Yep.
But there is Lele's on the bench, at least when there's Lele on the field now that won't be brought back to the deck, so that is 1-2 prize that he could do on a easy one-shot knockout. potentially there. So we just got to see how else it plays out on Wesley's side of the field.
We see the Lapras come down, like we were talking about. Definitely Nolan's primary attacker. That's why this deck is called Clap Back, Clap Press, baby.
So, is that what it's called, or is that what you just called it?
I've read it somewhere.
Cool.
On the internets. Max Elixir. High probability to hit.
I'm
going to
say the
second
card.
Second card? All right. Third.
36.
All right.
Divide those as the second card, so we're good.
Dare we say it again? Quick math. Cynthia coming in. He does have the water energy on that Remoraid, so he can manually retreat. Maybe Aqua Patch.
Hey, you know what? Interesting enough, if it's that one Remoraid, I can't tell by the art here, if it's the one that retreats the bench, you can save that for an energy switch play later.
Yep.
So that could be a unique thought there with that Remoraid.
However, if he is, he is the first turn of the game, so if he's doing that, it's on his second turn where he absolutely would rather be Blizzard Burning.
Yeah.
Cynthia coming up with six. Aqua Patch there. Did I see another Max Elixir and Octillery?
Yep. Hard retreat. See the Octillery in hand. And decent spot.
Two Aqua Patches is what we had there. Brooklyn Hill's going to stick. Mm-hmm. As we know, the only way that's coming off the board is if Nolan field blowers it away. I don't see that happening.
Mm-hmm.
So he will be able to do get at least another Lapras down and be able to Aqua Patch to it. Maybe energy switch that way. Manually attach, Aqua Patch, energy switch.
Yep.
Knockout.
Lots of plays. But Brooklyn Hill's always a tough thing to play because, you know, it's going to benefit. What, 90% of the field has Buzzwool.
Yep.
So, but you do need that setup. It's not playing Bridget. It's just going for the Brooklyn Hill to get the Pokemon out there.
Mysterious Treasure for Trubbish, Floatstone.
Right, he's hitting everything right now.
Okay, so Wes able to empty out his hand very quickly. Got a great setup on turn one, which is exactly what he wants to see. Limiting the amount of actual ability turns no one's going to have. The Octillery, the Aqua Tube off the Manaphy EX.
So if you're Null right now, do you go ahead and go right after that Trubbish, or are you just kind of just, you know, ignoring it at this point? Like, if I don't have abilities, I don't have abilities. It is what it is.
He does have the Field Blower. I don't think that's necessarily a dance he has to get into right now. His primary focus is on getting a Lapras built up and maybe gunning down one of these Buzzwolves before it gets
might
a belt
be your
on.
Time to shine here, Kirk. Can you go for it?
No, I'm not going to go for it.
Well, you know what? Good. Because those are three.
Nope. Everybody waiting with bated breath. I'm not going to go for it there. Order pad. Fail. Pass. Water off the top. We see Ultra Ball.
We're seeing similarities to game one to where Lily stuck into active more than two turn or more than one turn. So,
which Wes can't be happy about. He plays so many float stones.
Yep. And Nolan's not here. Are we going to see it just collect and go, or is what are we looking at here? Brooklyn Hill. Can we see the Volcanion, or are we going to go right to Lapras again?
I think he's thinking about that right now. Composition of his hand, one water energy, and a bunch of other stuff behind it.
Yes, so, there are cards there. I think a couple. Did we see Aqua Patches in the previous turn?
Those were End Away, right?
After the end. Did we see them after the end before you started next turn?
Well, maybe. We'll find out. We will find out. Time will tell, my friend Jeff, while he's going through his Brooklyn Hill search. Manaphy.
Interesting.
And he does have an Ultra Ball in his hand. Dumping a water leads me to believe, like you said, he's got an Aqua Patch, so maybe he can make those plays. Tapu Lele. Are we going to see a Guzma play? Guzma. Okay, so he's eyeing up that Buzzwool. No Fighting Fury Belts coming down. Mm-hmm. He's got the choice band on the Lapras. He can take out, exactly. Take it out before Wes has time to really set up.
Is that double Aqua Patch? I think that's double Aqua Patch and a water energy, so he's going to be able to just...
Guzma, double Aqua Patch, attach return, manually retreat. Beautiful.
That's so nasty.
If you're going to get one turn of Aqua Tube, this is a pretty good
way. And he has the Sycamore to follow the next turn. This is insane.
Double Aqua Patch.
You don't want to see that if you're West right now. That is...
That Lapras feeling real powered up right now. Going to get that free retreat.
Right,
Manaphy really showing why it's in the deck right here, allowing crazy plays like that. Keep in mind, we're in Beast Ring territory now. However, we see Buzzwool, Tapu Lele, basic fighting, Guzma,
and N.
Waving down, I'm going to be using Brooklyn Hill. interested to see what he would grab here. Baby Buzz makes sense.
I like it. You want to kind of slow down your opponent a little bit, make him take an awkward knockout.
Wes wants to hit a Fighting Fury belt. He wants to hit a Fighting Fury belt badly.
Fighting Fury belt, strong energy.
He wants something.
Everything. Beast ring.
He wants some beast rings. He's attaching fighting and crossing his fingers for some beast rings and a Fighting Fury belt.
Interesting, and I want to just clarify there, was the Octillery still in Nolan's hand after he did those mana play just now? Because if it was, I'm curious to why he didn't evolve it. I think it was there.
That's a great point. Maybe just a misstep. You know, when you get a little excited, you kind of got all the tools you need to take a big knockout and really put yourself on the front foot. Maybe it's just something that kind of slipped his mind and maybe thinking, I'll get it next turn. It is still in his deck. Two abilities are still live as we speak. What did Random Receiver, 2 energy, promote Baby Buzz, which means he did not get it. However, refreshing his hand gives Nolan another crack at a Guzma play.
Yeah, there's no Fighting Fury belt on that bench of Buzz, so you know, Brooklyn Hill for another Lapras or Volcanion.
Or Volcanion.
Yes, come on, bring the boy out.
Well, it'll make him escape rope.
Oh,
it'll
yes!
It'll make him escape rope. So that's a one-half escape rope. The ability
so
on Volcanion.
Think forced to bring up a knockout or the Trebuch.
Yeah, so that'll be Jet Geyser, I think is what it's called. Discard a water. It's half of an escape rope, so your opponent spins out.
So the only thing there is he's supposed to get the Lapras out of active to reset his attack. So there's going to be some kind of combo there to where he, I don't know, he can do a couple little things here. Or just set up his Lapras on bench.
Which is fine, too. I think, he's taking this turn of reprieve. It's obviously a tell when your opponent manually retreats into a non-attacker and says go. And
I'm curious to see here if Nolan just hits everything and gets a second Lapras set up with 3 energies and just retreats and gets the cycle going.
So we know
he's played 2 Aqua Patches, so he has 2 left.
Okay.
I believe we've seen 1 Max Elixir, so there's still 5 energy accelerators left. Oh, we'll get a skip right now.
Nope. 0% chance we're getting
tease.
That was a tease. You know, perfect world scenario. Nolan is only getting 4 cards here. However, like I said, ability's still on. There's a Max Elixir and 3 Sycamore.
All right. We're going with first card.
First card. All right. To be fair, you're like 1-for-14 on calling that.
You know what?
Actually, you're 50% because you've only done it twice. But I didn't want to give you too much credit, make your head get a little too big here.
You know what? It's already
there's barely
there,
enough
I appreciate
room for
you.
Us here in the booth, the proverbial booth, without your head getting too big. So,
I think, yep, retreat, collect, probably what we're going to see here. Or just a pass. Yep, there's a pass. Or the pad! We got there.
All right, we're back on it.
We're back on there. The light's back on.
And
pay
now
the electricity bill, we're back on.
we're in beast ring go mode. I'm not super certain Nolan properly identified what Wes had going on last turn when he retreated into the Buzzwool.
Mm-hmm.
After that end, if he had beast ring, if he had something else going on worthwhile, he would have done it.
Yep, very true.
But we see Nolan refreshed his hand to 6. And Beast Ring, Strong Energy, Floatstone, Garbodor, and he got it all.
He needs the belt.
He got it all. I mean, and that's not even a tall order right now because he hasn't seen any of this game.
If he hits the belt, we're taking his Lapras to the dojo and whipping it up. It's going down.
Yeah. We are going straight Karate Kid.
Karate Kid.
He is strapped up,
wax
ready to go.
Wax on, wax off. Bye-bye the Loch Ness Monster.
Nessie, never to be found again.
Never to be found again.
End of 4 for Nolan. The whole 6. order pad.
Wait. Okay. 3, 4, 5. I don't think.
Did
I
he
saw
miss it?
It?
Did
I
he miss
think
the
I
fighting
fury belt?
Belt?
He did not get it. Oh.
How many are prize? It's got to be. It's got to be more than one prize at this point.
Oh my goodness. The deception.
Absorption GX is going to take a KO here. Abilities not active, excuse me. So choice band water.
Which
water
I'm sure
too easy.
Slam it down as soon as possible.
Artillery
the Sycamore too.
Brooklyn Adult, for some reason I thought he was picking up his deck to Abyssal Hand. And I was gonna say, Nolan, what
there
are you
is.
Doing,
There's
my
There's the boy. Volcanion coming in hot.
I don't even think you want to use that here though.
Not right now. He's going. He already tested energy. He committed to the Lapras. Like, he's going for the knockout here.
Well, I mean, you can use the ability without. So he is sycamoring solely for the choice band here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that could be why he grabbed the Volcanic too, is one less card to run into.
Which totally reasonable, and the ability is not negligible either. All Nolan right, knows his tournament life depends on these seven. He needs a choice band.
Here we go.
Come on.
Show the love. E-switch. Oh, man.
I did not see it. I think
he's flooded with water right now. I don't see any choice bands, though. Guzma, energy switch, and I think Ultra Ball, three water.
Call him New Orleans, flooded with water.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Wow.
Oh, so that three, four waters? GX, paralyzed, not at all where Nolan wants to be. Wes.
Oh, man.
Wes, breathing.
Oh. He had a big sigh of relief.
Oh, no. Nolan announced Blizzard Burn.
Is that what it is?
Nolan announced Blizzard Burn.
Instead of
Ice Beam GX. He did make the motion to flip the GX marker. We'll see what the table judge has to say here. He flipped the GX marker, but he did announce Blizzard Burn. Jeff just ran to the table judge. What do you got, Jeff?
So Corey's currently got the ask the head judge what the ruling is here. So yes, Blizzard Burn was announced, but the GX counter was moved. So I'm not sure what the order of operations there as far as what happens.
Look, the old adage says actions speak louder than words.
Yeah, but in Pokemon, well, words have a very high standard.
Yeah, but words also in Pokemon rarely are associated with a distinct action of flipping over your GX marker. I hope for Nolan's sake he can get that Ice Beam GX off.
I 100% agree that I feel that it should just be the Ice Blade, Ice Beam play, and there's just a warning. Or maybe or some kind of penalty bar will be assessed, but I hope that the GX attack doesn't take into effect. But there has been instances before where, you know,
and
grabbing an N.
I'm assuming they still have their headphones on.
They do.
Yeah, they do. Okay, we just saw Wes lean in. Almost like a little bit of a psychic response to what I said. He's like, let me lean in and show him that we got it. Wes, if with Blizzard Burn named, that Buzzwole still live, doesn't need a Guzma to get it out of the active, and he has B-String if he wants to power up another Buzzwole.
This is so disheartening right now for Nolan. If it does go the way, unfortunately, I think it is going to go.
Unlike Bob Ross, this was an unhappy accident. Nolan really kicking himself right now. I really hope his wonderful tournament run doesn't lie on semantics.
It's so gut-wrenching to realize that something as, you know, small as minuscule as like saying their incorrect name.
Yeah. And it's important to clarify exactly what you're doing. However, in this exact particular circumstance, if it wasn't a GX attack and he had announced the incorrect attack, easy peasy.
Yep.
This, I think there's just an extra layer of complexity because he flipped the GX marker, but said Blizzard Burn.
So I'm assuming by what you're saying is you're pro that the GX attack should be the way it's presented.
That's my belief. Again, using the old adage, actions speak louder than words. Like, it's a physical commitment to making a move to your board to flip the GX marker. That is very clear intentions.
Okay.
And, you know, sometimes your mouth doesn't catch up to what your mind is doing.
All right, it looks like Corey's back and explain to him what's going on. Or someone's over there, whether it's Steve Lewis, who's the head judge of Madison this weekend, trying to decipher the situation. But I know they'll come over here with a report once we figure out what the decision is.
Let's tip our caps to the judge staff. They had a great weekend, did a great job, helped us out on stream, caught a lot of stuff, really keeping us on point, understanding exactly what's going on, how things are being assessed, exactly how things are being resolved, and keeping us kind of moving forward in a timely manner, adjusting the clock accordingly, awarding the time that the players deserve to have back when these type of things happen. Ooh, I'm...
Is this?
I think if...
The ruling was he used Ice Beam GX because he could play the GX with the intent to use it, and he accepted this one.
Okay, so okay.
He said Blizzard Burn meant GX.
Yes.
Okay. So we have...
Okay, so we're just going to go with that, no penalties, anything like that?
So as you'll see, damage is being added to the Buzzwole. The Buzzwole is turned for paralysis. We are able to stick to the old adage, actions speak louder than words, and that sometimes your mouth doesn't catch up with your mind.
Big sigh of relief for Nolan.
Yeah, in any other circumstance, I agree. If you announce the wrong attack, you announce the wrong attack. However, when you do a GX attack, it is stapled onto a physical action, and I think this is one of the few scenarios where you can, I don't want to say get away with, because you're not trying to trick anybody, but be able to, you know, make a case for going with the GX attack.
Fully agree. And like you said, the B stream is activated now, going on to that bench Buzzwole. But yeah, without the, he has two Guzmas here, so he can do a couple different plays here. You can take out that Manaphy, you can go after the Lele, a lot of little things that you can do.
Mystery Treasure pitching the Garbodor, just getting rid of Chaff in his deck, I believe, at this point. Mm-hmm. No bench spots available for the little bag of trash to sit down and take a rest. as you mentioned, he does have two Guzmas.
And I'm just curious what the route is here. Yep, with the Manaphy there. I think his thought is here is, you know, if Nolan does get to the Field Blower here, he doesn't want to give him the free ability to, you know, go across the seas that is active and bench between the Lapras. So.
Yep. So Tapu Lele coming up. It can hard retreat if he needs to. Maybe eyeing up Guzman play. I'm thinking Nolan really just wants this choice band to retreat into the Lapras, putting pressure on Wes to find something.
But I don't think we see it. He does have Sycamore. Does he just go for it?
I don't think you have the choice. I think you have to.
But it's two, looks like it's two Guzmas there. Maybe even three, actually. Hold on.
And he is running four Guzma in the list.
He caps out. I think he's going to do a little count on what he has left in his deck.
Brooklyn
as far
Hill.
As...
I'm just keeping an eye to see if he has another he has another Guzma to hit.
One or two Guzma, I think, are still from what I saw there.
Mm-hmm.
The research. If he does, you know, go a little aggro and drop it all.
So he two things he checked there. How many Guzmas do I have access to? How many choice bands do I have access to? Because he's going to need both to close out this game.
Oh, man. This is a...
Ultra ball. Get something else out.
I don't know what we're going to dump, but...
We have an energy switch as well. Not a lot of mileage out of this one, I don't think.
All right, so he's played Ultra Ball just to get rid of a couple of energies there. So he knows the Sycamoring. And here we go.
All right, we're looking for Choice Band. Guzma not pressing now, but definitely needed by before tonight.
There
choice
it is.
Band's
right,
there. Choice Band's there. So he gets to play on. Blizzard Burn coming in huge because there's enough damage on the bench to, and he had it aim. So the second Guzma able to...
Yeah, the third energy. So what's he knocking out without the...
Yeah.
Did he have a third energy to knock out whatever it was, like the Lele, I'm assuming?
Maybe the Buzz on the bench had three energy and just the way they're stacked, we didn't see it.
Okay.
Coming back to us in the booth here.
Absolutely.
Kind of a barn burner of a match.
Yes.
Came down to the wire.
But it just, you know, a couple pieces were just missed. On Nolan's end there, so but
just I was just taking a look at the discussion they're having. You know, we kind of get the split screen action here, just seeing what's going on. Hard earned win by Wes, very well played. Nolan kind of one turn off on that choice band, which gave Wes just a little bit of room to breathe to be able to take that down. We are definitely the last match to finish for this. So before we storm right into top eight, we're going to run some ads. I think we're going to forego the winner's interview here just to keep things rolling forward and making sure we can get into top eight in a timely manner because we're all running a little bit behind. Last two rounds kind of inundated with just some weird technical issues and things like that. So we're going to try and keep the pace of the stream moving forward. So on behalf of Jeff and myself, we will catch you for top eight. Thank you.